Hey everyone, it's Ellen here, and today I'm going to do things a little bit differently than normal. I don't have any sort of song tutorial for you. Instead, I have something very special to bring to you. You guys might know Michelle Arsenault or Guitar Goddess, and we actually were talking on Twitter for a while, and we decided to try to film like a conversation between us just about, you know, YouTube and guitar and things that we have in common. So we did, and I wanted to show you guys how that went. So we had to split this video up into different parts because it was quite long. And so this is part one, where you guys get to meet my puppy Ozzy, and we talk a little bit about how we started our channels. And it's really weird because we actually have very similar stories. And we talk a lot about copyright struggles and, you know, being signed with an MCN and things like that. If you don't know what that is, then definitely stay tuned because we go over all of that stuff. We talk about being partnered with YouTube and finding a good work-life balance between, you know, making our videos and stuff like that and resuming our natural social life. So anyways, we kind of go into all of that in part one. So if you're interested in what we have to say, then go ahead and keep watching. And oh, and I'll also link part two, which will be over on Michelle's channel right here. Or right here. I guess it should be in this corner. So definitely make sure to watch part two after you finish this video. I'll link it again at the end of the video. But yeah, that's it. So I hope you enjoy this collaboration Skype session between me and Guitar Goddess. And I hope that you find it entertaining. So yeah, bye. So what are some of the like most asked questions that you see in the comment section?
Most asked questions. I feel like I get a lot of beginner questions. I get like switching chords or bar chord questions, things like that. And I haven't made any videos on topics like that yet, but I get a lot of beginner questions. And the best way that I find to kind of answer those is you have to take baby steps when you start out, because, you know, everybody wants to play a full song right away. And that's a good goal to have, but you have to learn the chords and you got to get down the strumming pattern or the picking pattern, whatever it is, and kind of set the song aside in a way and break it down. And so really having patience with yourself and yeah, just taking it step by step. How about you?
I totally agree. I feel like a lot of times I get a lot of comments and people are frustrated because, you know, I label my tutorials as easy and then they're like, this isn't easy. But like, really, it just takes so much like practice and you just have to put in the time because it won't just come really easily, especially if guitar is your first instrument ever to learn. So I always try to emphasize that with people, like you have to give yourself time and like you said, baby steps. You got to do things one at a time, practice every day, and then you'll eventually get better and things will get easier and then it'll start to happen more naturally. So
exactly. I see your dog in the background.
He just had surgery, so he's got his cone on. Cone of shame.
I know. Oh my goodness, he's so cute though.
Thank you.
What's his name again?
It's Ozzy.
Ozzy.
Oh yeah.
Precious.
Thanks.
Oh, I know how the cone is because I've taken my cats back from the vet and they start running into stuff.
Yeah, oh my gosh, it's like really hindering his movement and I feel so bad, but like, he's a licker, so I gotta keep it on him all the time.
Aww, that's okay. So sweet. So, what got you started into making tutorials on YouTube? What kind of inspired you to do that?
Well, so I used to actually, I think we both kind of started out the same. I've been noticing with your really old videos, we kind of started with more like covers and fun stuff, just stuff that we wanted to do, like singing and doing covers. But then I remember the very first video I did with my guitar was Goodbye by Miley Cyrus, an oldie.
Okay.
Yeah, and like as I was doing my cover, almost every single comment was like, how did you play that on guitar? Can you teach me how to play that on guitar? So I remember I was in college at the time and I had a lot of free time. So I was just like, sure, why don't I upload a tutorial? So I did it. It was very raw, very like, there wasn't very many edits or anything. I didn't really think anyone would watch it. And I was like, well, here's how you play it for those five people who asked, you know. And then after that, people just were like, oh, I love your tutorials. You should make more. So then I just kind of, it went from there. So
that is amazing because your story is exactly my story, except just the song is different. It was Taylor Swift. It was the one in the Miley Cyrus movie.
Crazier.
Crazy. Yeah. That was the one because I covered it. Mm-hmm. Someone was like, can you make tutorials? So that's what I did. And I didn't know that you could learn guitar from YouTube at the time.
Right.
I think the only one teaching was maybe Marty.
Yes.
But I didn't even know him at the time. So same thing. I had a MacBook and I just sat down mm-hmm. and I think it was like a 10-minute video. And I literally taught it as if no one had even like had a guitar before or uh-huh. a pick. So I was explaining what everything was and people were like, just get to the
Well, hey, I mean, you got to cover your basics because you never know who's watching. So, but yeah, that is so funny. That's exactly the same story. How funny is that? But I remember my very first computer was like super old. It was an Acer, I think. The webcam okay. was so bad. Like my old videos are so blurry. They're terrible.
No, sorry. I wish I had my old videos up because that whole copyright thing I was telling you about.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Oh, I had to wipe most of my catalog. It was like almost 300 videos. And so I had all these, you know, songs that I did and most of them, yeah, were all like filmed on my MacBook and stuff. So it sucks. I don't have like that progression over
yeah.
time, you know, to see that. So,
did you not have time to like get all of the video from YouTube before like the copyright stuff happened or what?
Yeah.
Happened?
So I was pre-warned, which was good because I had two copyright strikes. And so I was talking to this guy. He used to work for Sony ATV Publishing.
Mm-hmm.
And so he started his own company called We Are the Hits, and that's that third party thing.
Mm-hmm.
And so I was talking to him and he was like, you're probably going to want to pull down all of your videos. And so I lost some of them in the fire because if it had a third party right claim on it,
you couldn't download it.
I couldn't download it.
Right.
It won't let you, download your video. So I only downloaded the ones that I could. And they're on one of my old MacBooks. Like, but it's like, it's kaput. It like doesn't work anymore because I edited so many videos on it.
Right.
And it died. But I think I can still access the hard drive if I like take it somewhere and maybe I can like get them back.
Yeah, no, you can actually get like an external hard drive, hopefully, if it works, because that's exactly what happened to my old computer. It was a Windows, or it was like a weird built computer, and so I took out the hard drive and I got an external, and I was actually able to extract a lot of the footage from it. So
nice.
Yeah, it was good, but I totally understand where you're coming from with the copyright thing. That was so hard back in the day. Like I was there too. Every single video I uploaded was copyright stricken, and like sometimes YouTube would just take down my video. I don't think that they even warned me because back then I used to make a lot of instrumentals so that people could sing to them, and because I advertised them as, you know, like Taylor Swift or whatever, it would get copyright stricken, and then they would just take it down. So that happened to, I think, three of my videos, no warning or anything. So it was terrible.
God.
Yeah, that sucks.
Because they sent you like an email.
Yeah, this was way back, like in 2009 type stuff. Like they just took it down. And they were all instrumental, so it wasn't too bad. Like they weren't tutorials or anything, but I worked really hard on them. So I was really upset about it.
Oh, the thing is, we couldn't even monetize them back then anyway. So we weren't even trying to make money.
I know.
So because the partner program wasn't a thing for you and I until I think like 2012, maybe
something like that.
Even later. Because like MCN started coming in and stuff like that, and that was a whole new game.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, like you and I were just making videos for fun
mm-hmm.
and not trying to like even benefit off of them.
I know.
Because like I was also in college when I first started, it was just a hobby. Like I worked part time and you know, instead of like, I really didn't go out and do anything. So, I would just like make videos and that was fun. Like that was so much fun because we had audiences to connect with and it just felt like a friend group.
That
was really cool.
Yeah.
So, but the partner program, have you ever been with an MCN or anything like that?
Yeah. So back in 2013, when they first like kind of started, I was with Maker Music or Maker Studios. And I mean, I don't really know if I knew what an MCN was. I just knew that they had approached me and they were like, hey, you can actually make money off your YouTube videos. And I was like, what? My interest is piqued. And so like I talked to someone from there and essentially they were saying they could help me with all the copyright type stuff that was going on at the time. So I was like, so you're telling me that if I sign with you, I can put my videos up and I don't have to worry about them getting copyright strikes and my channel getting taken down. And they were like, yes. So then I just signed with them and I was with them all the way up until like 2015, 2016. And then I switched over to full screen because Maker actually, I think somebody like took over, like somebody bought Maker Studios. And at that point they kind of actually, they got rid of me because I wasn't getting enough views or anything for them. So they cut my contract off. But luckily,
wait, you weren't getting enough views for them? Your videos, I remember, like, even just a few years ago, like, you, like, had big views on some of your videos.
I did, but, you know, at the like, the biggest videos that I have on my channel don't make any money, and I don't know if that's something that an MCN is interested in, is, like, how much money they can generate, but, like, they all got copyright stricken, but not to the point where they would, like, ding my channel, but just to the point where I wasn't making money. Do you know what I mean? And so, yeah. So I think at that point, even though I was garnering a lot of views, I wasn't getting paid for any of those views. Therefore, they weren't getting paid for any of those views, so they dropped me.
So, I see. Okay, yeah. That makes sense. I was with, this, and this didn't even make sense, but Style Hall was an MCN, and they approached me, and they're more for, like, the fashion beauty bloggers, so I, you know, was kind of confused, and they partnered up my channel and they automatically started monetizing my videos. And like, wait a second, how does this make sense? And it was crazy because I didn't go in and just go like monetize. Mm-hmm. I just logged in one day and I saw a bunch of just like green dollar signs.
Yeah.
And so then my videos started making money, and then that's kind of what got me in trouble, was because they had monetized my videos, and then that whole copyright thing, and that's what happened. And so,
but you would think,
one big confusing mess.
Yeah, you would think that they would have known that that would happen, though, right? Before monetizing all of the copyrights?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's crazy.
Really weird. And then when I had the opportunity to leave them, I did, and didn't look back, because they started changing. They literally changed their contract because I had signed to an agreement, and then they're like, we're going to change the way that we're paying you out. And they're basically cutting my pay. And I'm like, no, this isn't right.
Yeah.
You agreed that we're going to like bump up my pay
after
this much time. And so I haven't been with an MCN since I want to say late 2014.
Really?
Yeah. It was like fall of 2014. Yeah. I've been independent ever since. And, I did sign with We Are the Hits at MCN, like they're third party. They don't actually like, they're not attached to my channel. They made me make a private YouTube channel to upload there. And then that way the videos connect to their CMS system. And then they take that video and it claims my public video. So I've been doing that for a while. And then a few of my friends told me, you don't need to do that. You can just upload straight through YouTube and monetize, because now YouTube just like does it in-house, and so they enabled the revenue share, and that's what I've been doing since early this year, like about the spring, and I've had no problems with it so far. Not that much.
Yeah, I didn't know about like, well, I mean, I knew about YouTube just being able to be your partner and like uploading straight to YouTube, but I don't know why I've been so afraid to make that transition. Like, I don't know, I'm so afraid of all the copyright stuff happening all over again.
I was scared too. Believe me, I freaked out so many times. My friends kept telling me, no, you can do it, it's okay. But I'm like, no, I got dinged in the past, and I don't want to get dinged again. So literally, it took me months to do this. So I started just one video at a time. I slowly did it. It was like baby steps for me, because I was so nervous.
Yeah.
And so then I finally did it, and I mean, I've uploaded a lot of videos this year, and it's been fine, but I've had a couple of videos get, like, the yellow demonetization thing. Like, when I went live one time, I didn't put in the title or description that I was going to play cover songs, but somehow it identified
them. Yeah. Oh, my my gosh.
Yeah, it was really smart. I don't know how I did that. Google is really reaching new levels.
Yeah.
I've had only a couple of those. But I remember the demonetization thing was a huge issue for all creators.
Yes.
And I've only gotten dinged like maybe two or three times with that and then lucked out, I guess. I don't know.
Wow, that's so interesting. But it sounds like so much, like you sound like you have so much knowledge about all this kind of like behind the scenes stuff. Have you like been researching it a lot or?
You know, I get a lot of questions actually about this. Like, how do you put covers or tutorials out there without getting in trouble? And a lot of people don't know that you can actually do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, I'm one of them. Like, I was so confused about this whole thing.
We're going to change that.
Maybe one day when I get a little more courage, but.
Yeah. You know, easier way into it. I don't want to pressure you into it, but definitely consider it because, you know, you put a lot of work into your videos. Mm-hmm. And I know that we're not, you know, trying to like, you know, get money and stuff like that, but you know, it helps us, you know, up our gear, you know, our camera, yeah. Microphone, all that stuff, buy new SD cards because they break down and all of that stuff. Or, you know, our computers, like I know we've both been through our share of computer issues too. Mm-hmm. And so having the gear to process all of these videos is really important. So it helps having that ad revenue come in.
Yeah, I totally agree.
So I'm trying to think what else we were kind of talking about. I know you were mentioning the struggle between kind of like a work-life balance between YouTube and your personal life.
Mm-hmm.
So how are you working on that right now? Because I know you were kind of telling me you feel like, you know, you want to be in editing a video, but then you want to hang out with your friends. And
right. I mean, I think everything we've talked about so far kind of like comes into it just because like I said, a lot of my videos that I upload don't get monetized, so I don't really make money from them. And so for me, this YouTube channel is more just like a hobby, like legitimate just a hobby. And so, you know, like with any hobby, like you don't want to like spend all your time doing it. So I just feel like, especially now that my videos, I feel like are getting a little bit more detailed with the editing, it takes so much longer to do. And so I don't know, personally, I feel like I like run out of steam sometimes. I'm like trying to, you know, edit 5 videos at once, or I'm trying to film on this day and then edit all the other days. And I don't know, sometimes it feels like very lonely being in front of your computer all the time. So I kind of crave, you know, the days that I get to hang out with my friends and like do other things and stuff. So I think I've like found a good balance between it, because what I'm doing now is every month I get 2 weekends to go out with my friends and be social and do whatever. And then the other 2 weekends I focus hardcore on my YouTube channel, whether that be filming or editing or like this today, you know, like doing this collaboration. So I think so far it's been doing pretty well because my videos have been getting up a little bit quicker than they used to.
Yeah.
Not as much as I would like to, because my goal is to have 2 videos up a month, which I know like for every other YouTuber, that's like, that's an easy goal. But for me, like that's my personal goal, just because like I remember last year I was uploading like 1 every like 3 or 4 months, which is just unacceptable. So I'm trying to like push myself to like get more consistent with my uploads and stuff. But have you figured out anything with you how to like balance that?
I have a lot of videos now kind of set to the side, a lot of stuff that's pre-filmed but just needs to be edited.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm trying to not do just songs because I find that kind of digs the hole for me, because those are the most highly edited videos and take the most time.
Right.
So I've been trying to do other content. I've been getting more into vlogs, actually. And I've been sharing my progress on electric guitar.
Mm-hmm.
I just uploaded an unboxing today. So it's like different pieces of guitar, still guitar related, but just different content and other ways that I can educate and share my knowledge. And so that's something I found that is definitely helping, because my goal is 3 videos a week, and that's still a lot, because I do this full time now, which is a blessing. It's been a hobby for a long time, but it's still, you wouldn't think it would be a struggle to get 3 videos out a week, and I've talked to other creators and they struggle with that too. And so some of them aim for just like 1 big high quality video a week, but I'm trying to do maybe like 1 song tutorial a week, maybe 2, and then a couple, like 1 maybe like just easier video. So I've been trying to do that. But just the process of like setting up and getting ready and all of that, it takes time. And so another thing that kind of follows with this that I want to do is have a separate space other than maybe my bedroom, because I've been filming in my bedroom the whole like 9 years or so I've been on YouTube. And so I have like a space over to the side where it works and I film there, but everything's kind of accumulating in my bedroom. Like, I have multiple guitars in here. I have two soft boxes off to the side, my camera, and I'm just kind of running out of space.
Yeah.
And I kind of just want to have a place where I can chill out in my bedroom and not have it feel like I do all of my work in here. So I do live at home with mom and dad, and my brother actually just moved back and he finished school. Mm-hmm. So there's no like extra room.
Right.
So we have a basement that's unfinished, and we're talking about the possibility of maybe building me a studio in there. So I'm going to have to like, you know, pay for that, but in the long run, it might actually
That would be so cool.
Room.
Yeah.
You know?
That sounds so awesome. I wish I had like an extra room or something like that to do that with. But like, I don't live in a house. Like, I live in an apartment, so there's only like 3 rooms to begin with, you know?
Yeah.
But I am going to be moving soon, hopefully in the next few months. So I'm actually trying to look for not like a 2-bedroom, but at least a bedroom, 1-bedroom where there's like an extra room for me to film. Because like you said, like just setting up alone can take forever. And then like you sit down and you have to film everything. And then it, like for me, I mess up all the time because I'm not very I'm not very good at talking. So I just, and then of course for editing, then I have to cut out all the little mistakes that I make when I'm talking. And so it's a really long process, but I totally think having a room dedicated for YouTube would be such a good idea. I think that's so cool that you're having that ability hopefully soon.
I think that, yes, that'll probably work a lot better there. But yeah, like, I think that's going to help you out a lot. It's just, it's a huge time saver. And I notice a lot of YouTubers have this. It's just like an extra bedroom that they use. And you keep everything set up. Mm-hmm. And like, all you have to do, you don't have to worry about focusing. You just sit down and it's ready.
Yeah.
And that's what I want. Because every time I have to tear down and put it all away, and you know, then if laundry gets involved in here, like it's a mess. Right. It's hard keeping this clean in here.
Yeah.
And so yeah, it's been a little bit of a struggle with that, but yeah, I think that's going to be great for you to just have that and not have all your, you know, your gear everywhere. Because I did it in an apartment too one time when I did work a 9-to-5. I lived about 3 hours from home. And I just filmed in my living room area. Mm-hmm. And I did that. And this was so crazy at the time because I got this new job, and I think I was off of YouTube for 2 or 3 months because I was just getting acclimated to this new job.
Right.
It was a management position. So I was just really busy. And I remember when I finally got the hang of it, I wanted to do YouTube so bad. I missed it. And so I literally had to, thank goodness, I actually lived on site. I was in property management. So I lived in an apartment complex that I also like worked for.
Oh, cool.
So my commute was like 30 seconds.
Yeah.
So I could come home for an hour during my lunch break, and I actually filmed videos on my lunch break and then just took food with me back to my office and like ate as I worked.
Oh,
and
my
then
gosh.
I edited like either at night or on the weekend.
That sounds nuts. So crazy. Oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
It was insane, but I wanted it like so bad because I missed making videos.
Yeah.
And so like, I feel your struggle because you said you work and you still go to school, right?
Yeah. Right now I'm not in school, but I think hopefully if everything goes according to plan, I will be trying to get my master's degree in the fall. So then I will be going back to school. But like for most of my life, like since I've been out of college, I've been in a healthcare setting. So I do a lot of like volunteer work with like nursing homes and stuff like that. Then I have my full-time job. And then I also was still going to school back then to, you know, further my education and stuff like that. So YouTube for a long time was at the like background of what I was doing because I was trying to get my like actual like life together. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But no, it's been really good lately because a few months ago I got a new job and now it's not. So I used to work at a hospital. So, you know, sometimes I have to be clocked in at 6 a.m. and then sometimes I would leave at like 11 p.m. So my schedule was just like all over the place. And it was really hard to find a time to do YouTube. But now luckily I have this new job and it's like you said, an 8 to 5, like all the, you know, my hours are set Monday through Friday.
Yeah.
So it's so much easier because now I know like, okay, the weekend's coming up. It's going to be YouTube weekend. Like now it's time to like sit down and focus and, you know, get everything done. So it's been a lot easier. And I think that's what's been helping me get more videos out recently is just the amount of time that I have to like actually spend doing it. So. All right, so you just watched part one of the Skype session that me and Michelle had. So if you are interested in listening to the rest of what we were talking about for our long conversation that we had, then definitely click here and this will take you over to the second part of this video, which is over on Michelle's channel. And yeah, thanks so much for watching and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.